bow and worship to him and just continue fasting and praying and seeking him tonight. Father God, we just come before you. We are so honored to be in your presence. God, we're so honored, Father, that you are our creator, our God, our Savior, our King, our Lord. We invite your presence, Holy Spirit. And God, I just pray that each one here tonight that has been truly seeking your presence and seeking the Holy Spirit in their lives, Father, will just expect great and mighty things from you tonight. And I pray, God, Lord God, that they would expect to take their faith to another level. Father, that you would perform your wonderful holy spiritual gifts, that each one would be seeking the gifts of your Spirit and the presence of your Spirit, Father, that we can go out in grace to honor you. So we come together, Father, tonight, and just seeking your presence, seeking the goodness that you have for us, and we are expecting wonderful things to happen because we've asked in faith, and we trust you in faith, so we believe, and we stand together. So we praise you, Father, be with those who are just feeling led to share tonight through worship, through word. I just pray that you would guide this evening, Father, every step, and that you, your Holy Spirit, would lead each of us in your presence to encourage one another tonight. We praise you and we love you, Father. In Jesus' name, amen.
Standing in your presence. Who here is thankful that God's love never gives up on us? Our theme for tonight was repentance, and I'm just feeling really heavy. You know, no matter what we do, as long as we bring it to God and we clear our hearts and we repent of those things, He still loves us and He still carries us through. And I just pray tonight that everyone can just find those things in your life that are holding you back from God. We all have them. Just let them go. Let them at Jesus' feet. Ask Him for His forgiveness, because there's no way that we can truly be as close to God unless we keep repenting daily and just giving it to God daily. And I know many of you here, like, your desire is to just, you long to be closer to God, and that's how we do it. We lay it at His feet and we give it to Him, and we just keep pushing forward. So let's just remember that as we continue to worship.
Oh, Thank you. Thank you. feel strongly that the Holy Spirit's ready to break loose and ready to do something, but we're still holding back. There's still some resistance in the atmosphere, but He's ready. He's so ready. I'm not going to share my entire testimony, but there's part of it that I felt led to share tonight, and that's this. I grew up in a very legalistic home, and I didn't truly know what it was to have a real relationship with God. I didn't know what it meant to truly worship Him. And I grew up thinking I was this good Christian and that I knew God so well. And I seeked Him and kept failing over and over. I just couldn't find Him. I just couldn't get into a relationship because I couldn't feel Him in my life. I walked away from Him for quite a while, and I lived a life of sin, terrible life of sin. But praise the Lord, one day, in a little church in Fairborn, Ohio, I found Him again. And I gave my life to Him, and I began to realize that there was something different this time than there was any other time that I had came back to God. Because I felt Him different than I ever had before. But there was still some of that bondage from the legalism that I grew up in, where you had to dress a certain way and had to look a certain way. Your hat had to be a certain way. And you just had to be a certain way in order to be a Christian. And it wasn't until 2 years later that I went to a little church, well, a big church actually, and I sat down. And I went there thinking, man, this church is crazy. Man, this church is crazy. And one day, I lifted my hand in the air during worship, and I felt every chain fall off of me. Every chain fell off of me of the legalism that I thought was nothing. And I began to know Jesus. I don't mean just the name of Jesus. I mean the power of praising Him. I mean the power of worshiping Him. I mean the chains falling off. Freedom in the name of Jesus. I stood up that day a new person in Him. I stood up that day so free because I found something called the Holy Spirit. I found something different than just Jesus. I found the true and living God. The true and living God. Not just the God that you read about in the Bible, but the God that is still alive and still present today. And all it took was to truly worship. All it took to truly praise Him. Let's praise Him tonight. Let's worship Him. I'm not talking about just what's going on here in the platform. I'm not talking about the music that's going on. Let's praise Him in our prayers. Praise Him and just give it all over to Him. We all still have some chains. We all still have some bondage. But tonight, it's all going to fall off. Tonight, we're going to see breakthrough. We're going to see freedom. We're going to see relief from things that we've been trying to give up for years and we just haven't been able to give them up. We're going to see change in Bedford County, in the state of Pennsylvania, in this nation, in this world. We're going to see lives changed because we're here and we're seeking it. Let's enter back in and just, let's go for it. Let's just give it all to Him and give up our chains and our shackles. No more shackles, no more chains. Break them off.
there's somebody here that's still not believing that, that they're not feeling that they're a child of God. And it's time for you to let go. Whatever it is that's holding you back, the fear, the anxiety, whatever it might be, let it go. Drop the chains. He's reaching his hand out. He's ready for you to take that step with him, but you can't do that until you leave it all. Stop living in fear of what's going on in the world around you. Stop living in fear of what people might think or what, you know, anything. Just let it go. Because you are a child of God. You don't need to live in the fear that's encompassing our world today. We don't need to live in that fear because we serve a mighty God who is more powerful than any of that. So I'm just asking that you can just find it in your heart to let it go. Let those chains fall today and believe that you are a child of God.
Expected to be here tonight, but we're all gathered, aren't we? Why don't we get around and start praying? Why don't we join together in seeking the kingdom of God, crying out to Him, asking Him to come on our behalf? Can we join together? Let's get in the circle here. Let's begin to pray and seek the Lord. That's what we're after. We've got to move the heavens, and when we do, we move it in prayer. Amen.